Last week, I got to meet a couple artists whose work I've seen and really enjoyed for a number of years. Dean Dass and Randy Bolton work primarily on paper and show at the Schmidt Dean Gallery. Their shows coincide with a third show of prints by such masters as Toulouse-Lautrec, Milton Avery, and E.L. Kirchner. These three exhibitions demonstrate the enormous vitality and creative range that characterize works on paper.
That's by
James Ensor. And this is a Kirchner, and there's a Beckmann. And what's this, another Kirchner? No, it's a Rick Heckel, yeah. Oh my God, these are great prints. You know, there's this whole Philographica thing going on, right? We're gonna look all over, and there's the Auerbachs over there. I mean, we're gonna look all over town before we see any prints like these. I'm bringing some students up for this conference. They're looking for grad schools and just to be a part of the whole scene and world. And I can't wait to bring them to this. I think it's cool to show in a gallery that includes this kind of work.
Get the middle one. Where is it?
It's kind of funny that it's all a lot of tongue-in-cheek references to, certainly that piece references Hocus Eyes. Woodcut, woodblock prints.
He did 100 and you only did...
He did 100 or more of views about Fuji, and I was teasing Chris, saying that I was able to cover it in three. This, that, and the other.
What else needs to be said?
You know, these paintings tease the edges of formlessness, right? They're trying to be both a shape, a cloud, a great shape, but also kind of dissolving. All along when I'm working on them, you know, through the layers of paper, recto and verso, I'm thinking about that tension between surface and space and form and formlessness.
Do you just start these on blank paper, or do you do preliminary drawings?
Yeah, blank. Paper is not blank. Paper is a living thing. Paper breathes. And I'm just working on the most sensitive papers I can find. And often they're handmade papers out of Gampi or Mitsumata fiber, but more often they're papers from Japan or Korea or the Philippines.
I think feel fortunate to have a real strong kind of art history background, especially as it relates to printmaking. That kind of awareness of the past and of the traditions of print, of printmaking, what prints were meant for, what was their purpose, what audience that they reached. I thought a lot about that, and I want my work to kind of blend into that tradition. So there's this tradition in printmaking about social commentary, the ability to make the work in large quantities rather than being one of a kind. There's multiples, and so that allows you to have a wider audience for your work. In other words, printmaking was intended or designed as a medium to exchange information, to disperse and exchange information among a wide audience. So prints originally were offered at a relatively inexpensive price, and that way the audience grew, the ideas were exchanged. I kind of held on to that. So once again, it's just that tradition of printmaking having kind of the element of commentary. So I think about like a Goya print or a Daumier. I feel so kind of related to that sense of purpose about what a print is meant for, what its audience is, and why you make a print.
Thank you. before he leaves, get over here for one question, Dean. Dean told me something that you may not be aware of, and I think it threatens your aesthetic. He said that the younger artists in college, irony is out. How do you respond to that?
I think it was out, but I've noticed it coming back into play. I mean, I think it's true. Our students, they have a...
They're sincere.
We were just talking about this idea about authenticity and like originality, and are the younger students or younger artists really firmly believe that they could recapture that kind of spirit of originality, and they do that through the sincerity in their own work.
But what about the idea of humor? Is that an offshoot of irony, or...?
Well, irony... When you're ironic, you say the opposite of what you mean in order to mean the opposite of what you say, right? So what are you going after, right? What's the target? So
that's not funny, what is?
There's a great Donald Cuspid essay a long time ago where he ranked kind of this idea about humor. He put irony and satire at the top, and then wit.
Being the most sophisticated.
Yeah, and then kind of like humor, you know, what we think of as this kind of ha-ha funny being at the lower level of that notion. So he really ranked absurdity, wit, irony, satire above just kind of jokey.
So the less you laugh at it, the better it is?
I don't know.
That was meant to be ironic.
If the milk comes out your nose, you're
The laughter has to hurt a little bit.